It feels like humans are always inventing new things and forever needing more energy and more power to make it all work. And in theory, any civilization that continues to grow for long enough will eventually need access to all of the energy on their home world. So where does that leave us? Welcome to Unveiled, and today we're exploring the extraordinary possibility that humans might never become a Type 1 civilization.
Are you a fiend for facts? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more fascinating content.
And heads up, this is a two-part episode, so check out part two via the link in the description. By Type 1 civilization, we mean Type 1 on the Kardashev Scale, a system devised by the Soviet astronomer Nikolai Kardashev in the mid-1960s. Although it has since been extended, the original scale goes up to Type 3, which relates to any civilization which has harnessed the power of its entire galaxy. To make it to Type 1, however, all you need to do is gain total control over the energy and power from your home planet, from Earth in our case. And so now that the scene is set, our hypothetical future awaits. Picture this. The year is 2120 by most optimistic predictions, and humanity has finally done it. We've built the solar panels, the geothermal collectors, the windmills, and are finally on the brink of officially becoming a Type 1 civilization. We've got just one last solar collection satellite left to launch, and we're primed to celebrate in parties all across the globe. But as the countdown to that momentous moment hits zero, the satellite doesn't launch. Instead, there's an explosion in the distance. The lights go out, and as you gaze up into the darkness, you see eerie, unearthly ships descending from the sky above. Okay, so an alien invasion might not be the most likely reason why we'll never make it to Type 1 on the Kardashev scale, but we can't completely strike it off the list of potential reasons either. And to understand why, we need to talk about something called the Great Filter, first proposed by the economist Robin Hanson. The Great Filter theory suggests that an unknown something happens to most civilizations in the cosmos when they reach a certain level of advancement. It's usually proposed as a possible answer to the Fermi paradox, the idea that given the many billions of planets there are in the universe, it's strange that we haven't discovered aliens yet. In the context of the Fermi paradox, the Great Filter is what prevents an alien species from reaching a level at which we or any other civilization might discover it. In the context of the Kardashev scale, the Great Filter is whatever prevents us from moving up it. The problem is, we don't know what the filter is, even if it exists at all. And in fact, one argument is that we may have already passed it, that abiogenesis, the very emergence of life, is the filter, and we've already beaten it, and that's why life is so rare. But another argument is that the Great Filter actually comes into play in our future, potentially somewhere between where we are now on the Kardashev scale, a lowly 0.7, and the fabled Type 1. After all, what better moment could there be for it to reveal itself than when we essentially complete life on Earth? So here are four of the dreadful, but also dreadfully interesting, Great Filter candidates that could await us, ready to block our way to the stars. Two in this video, and two in part two. The first Great Filter candidate is that we'll simply run out of resources. History shows us how we've generally needed to go through the coal age to get to the nuclear age, or how solar panels have been made using petrochemicals, or how nuclear power uses the same basic turbine as a steam engine does, only without needing the coal. The point is that as much as we're now left wishing we'd never used fossil fuels, it would have been pretty hard to get to where we are now without them. And we're not done yet. If we're ever going to Type 1 style harness all the energy our planet has to offer, we're going to need more gigantic leaps forward with the likes of wind, geothermal, and solar power. But collecting all that juice requires infrastructure, and that means a huge initial outlay of, well, energy. And until we achieve true carbon neutral living, a lot of that energy is still gained using fossil fuels, which one, pollute, and two, run out. Through the lens of the Great Filter, that second one could soon be a major issue. Because what happens if we use all the fossil fuels up before we've got enough sustainable energy sources to replace them? Estimates vary, sometimes wildly, but we could have somewhere between just half a century and a century and a half before there's literally no more gas left in our planet's tank. That is, not enough oil, coal, and natural gas left in the ground to keep the economy running even like it is, let alone like it could be in the future. If we run out at any stage without a solution, we can kiss our hopes of getting to Type 1 firmly goodbye. In fact, we could quickly be moving backwards, as all our existing industries would grind to a halt. There is a solution, though, and it effectively amounts to, let's be smart with what we've got. It's been said, for example, that it is possible to gather enough solar energy to power the whole world's electricity. Again, estimates vary. But with panels over a surface area of somewhere between 40,000 and 200,000 square miles, we could do it. Take that surface area and place it in the middle of something vast like the Sahara Desert, and we could theoretically build for ourselves a power hub for the entire planet. If a project like this were to be completed quickly and efficiently, then we still could replace fossil fuels before they run out. We needn't rely on a limited source. But of course, in the meantime, fossil fuels pose arguably an even greater threat still. Not only are they running out, but they're threatening our survival as they do. Our second great filter candidate, then, is self-annihilation. Now, if this one was to play out with humanity in the near future, it wouldn't necessarily be only our use of fossil fuels that was causing it. There are other ways we can self-annihilate. But regardless, most climate scientists agree we're now beginning to see the more serious effects of global warming come to the fore. Most obviously, we've seen weather extremes happen all across the world map, from widespread fires to devastating droughts to mass flooding. And many of the measures we use to gauge our planet's health are heading in the wrong direction too, including ice coverage, which is decreasing, and average temperatures, which are increasing. One reason humanity might never become a Type 1 civilization, then, is that we ourselves contribute to the environment on Earth no longer being able to host us. But we also know that polluting our way off the planet isn't the only self-inflicted apocalypse on the table either. Looking into the future, and we still have the familiar specter of a potential nuclear apocalypse to contend with, plus other war zone concerns like bioweapons, as well as a series of new but also extremely worrying plausibilities like the prospect of a rogue AI. All of those things ultimately amount to byproducts of our technological advancement, though. So might it be possible that the real reason we've never discovered aliens is that all species eventually, inevitably, create a technology that becomes their death sentence? When you consider that there's an estimated 14,000 nuclear weapons on Earth today, enough, under certain circumstances, to systematically destroy the total landmass of our planet, there's an argument that humanity is already on this particular precipice, that its route to Type 1 will one day be ended by a disaster of our own doing. So how do we solve this one? There's a saying that an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. And that's one approach here. Unfortunately, nuclear, chemical, and even robotic weapons are now all known about. They're here, and while many nations and organizations have scaled back, it's not as though the knowledge of them will disappear. But still, the more smart and responsible decisions we make now, the less likely we are to blow ourselves up tomorrow. In theory, at least. Ironically enough, however, another way to sidestep this whole self-annihilation thing lies in becoming a Type 1 civilization itself. While something like the nuclear destruction of planet Earth would clearly be a devastating blow for humanity at any time, for Type 1 humanity, it needn't be terminal. And that's purely because we wouldn't all necessarily be on planet Earth. Instead, we'd be busy trying to become a Type 2 society and spreading ourselves across the solar system. And the more people we have off Earth in space stations and on different planets, the easier it should be to ensure the collective survival of humankind. So self-destruction is a reason why we might never become Type 1, but our becoming Type 1 could also be the reason why it never happens. And that's your first two scenarios that might cause humanity to never become a Type 1 civilization: running out of resources and self-annihilation. Maybe the outlook for our species improves in the second part of this two-part special. Maybe it doesn't. You'll have to watch to find out.
What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.